And finally, we saved the best for last, the rock and roll anthems. These are kind of basically just five songs which, for Joel, embody
in the
lifestyle, the music, everything, the spirit of rock and roll.
All right, well, we'll kick it off. Yeah, okay, I think I've almost got this in an order here. We're going to go... look, let's just kick it off and just punch everybody in the face with Motorhead. All right? Rock and roll. We played it last time, but play it again. This is Rock and Roll. It's by Motorhead. It's a great rock and roll anthem. He says rock and roll about 100 times in the song. So if you didn't get it the first time, you'll get it. It's a fist raiser.
There was your song on the first album, Stand Up for Rock and Roll, and you're telling me about the time you're in the studio with the producer. And
yeah.
Like, Joel, I think you're saying rock and roll too many times in this song. Yeah. You're like, have you heard Motorhead rock and roll?
Yeah, well, that's it, you know what I mean? You can never say rock and roll enough times in a song, I reckon. You know, it's great.
I reckon Lemmy got you there.
Yeah. look, we're on tour with them at the moment. We'll play Maiden. We're going to go Running Free live from Donington.
Okay.
Yeah.
A specific year, or is there an album we can get that off?
No, you can get it. You can get it off, it's 92.
Okay.
You can get it. There was a Best of the Beast live album, two discs.
Yeah.
It's on one of those discs. And it's a stomping.
How do you, when you're on the road and stuff, are you just playing music all the time on this bus? Because it seems to me like you've heard every song, every album. Like, a lot of people just have heard the big albums, the big tunes.
Yeah.
You've got the B-side albums, the live albums.
Yep.
Is it just all your life?
It is, mate. I never got into, you know, full-on hard drugs. I got into rock and roll, and that is my drug, basically.
Yeah. Like, and you're addicted.
Yeah, and alcohol. For me, like, I mean, the other night we're on the bus, you know, and we had a couple of nights off, so it was like, I started playing, you know, just a few tunes. I was like, I was pretty fucked after the gig, and I was like, just having a few beers, and we're playing a few tunes. And then I just started having a few beers and a few tunes. I was like, yeah. And then the next thing I know, we're up till like, the sun had well and truly come up. We're up till like, you know, it was 1 o'clock the next day, just still rocking and drinking. We played everything. And it was just like, oh, this one, you know, went through the whole fucking... a lot of it, you know, it was great. And it's just one of those things where with the right songs and the right, you know, alcohol,
the right pacing as well, because you don't want to shoot your load too soon.
I threw up a bunch of times. That's it. Like, I threw up a bunch of times. It's like, and you pass out and then you just go boom, you're back, and then you're off rocking again. It's so much fun. It's like, I mean, like, you could take speed if you want and then just go fucking ever, but it's sort of like,
but you don't need it.
No, you don't, with the right songs you don't, you know what I mean? It's sort of like if you're listening in, if you're in a club and they're playing all this shit and you're just like, oh, this is fucked, you
know? Yeah,
well then you're gonna need to take everything to deal with that.
Yeah,
but, you know, you don't want to be there. But if you want to be there, it's different. It's like being playing a gig.
Yeah,
it's like you just fucking, let's fucking power drink and rock, you know.
There's a look in your eye when you get on stage. I've only seen you live twice now, but I've noticed it every time, having spoke to you before, like before a show or just, you know, after or whatever. And when you get on stage, your eyes are like five times brighter than when you are now, and it looks like you're on something, but of course you're not. It is just the music, but there is a notable change in you, and obviously all performers experience that, but there's a definite kind of Jekyll and Hyde thing almost with you.
Yeah, you just sort of like, it's just that thing, you just it's a flip of the switch. It's like, yeah, like, I think we talked about murderers and stuff.
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
it's that
on the Gibson bus that's on this fair.
Yeah. So it really is like a serial killer. You just don't, no one knows why they do it. They don't even know why they do it.
But he ain't killing anyone.
Nah, just,
other than the crowd with his tunes.
I've got an axe though.
Yeah.
So I'm kind of like an axe murderer, but not
an axe wielding maniac.
Yeah, there you go.
Sent forth to rock the crowd.
Yeah. All right. So we've done Running Free. I think look, let's do Long Way to the Top, AC/DC. I mean, that's a rock and roll.
Well, anthem. And not many bands get away putting bagpipes into that rock and roll mix. And
yeah, they sure did. And well, back to the guitar talk from before, they actually had the tune up. Oh, it's tune up, I think, to the, or down a little bit for the bagpipes.
Yeah.
So they had to actually tune the guitars to the bagpipes to get it work, because you can't. I actually used to play the bagpipes.
Really?
A long time ago.
Would you ever get them out on stage now?
Nah.
Leave that to Jonathan Davis.
Yeah, you know, and you can't tune, like, it's not 440.
Yeah.
It's not just in standard tuning. You actually have to change the tuning guitar. So they actually changed that. And it's got a unique riff to the guitar. Like, there's such a simple riff to it, but and then the song comes in, it's such a big, great chorus, you know. It really is a long way to the top. They're not joking there.
Yeah.
You know, that's great. All right, and we'll play
So we've got three there. We've got three. Two more to go.
Yep, we're going to go. Here's a Roast Adu song called We Can't Be Beaten. It gets played at all big Australian sports events. You know, when Australia...
It's one of those anthemic.
Yeah, it is. You know, when Australia wins gold in the swimming or something, you know, they'll play that, you know.
Really?
Well, in the pub. Yeah.
Okay.
The Olympics, they'll play...
You
they'll
can't
play,
imagine that happening in England. Like,
nah, they'll play...
Let's get on the stones.
Yeah, they'll play Land Down Under or something like that, you know. Vegemite sandwich and shit. That's right.
Probably, but in the bars, that's probably, what people
yeah,
will be.
They'll probably change the lyrics over here with a Marmite sandwich. But yeah, we can't be beaten. I've seen it at sports stadiums in Australia before, and it just gets the whole crowd going. You know, it really is. And we talked about Rose Tatum before. This should have made him the biggest band in the world, this song. We can't be beaten. You can't. Can't top, it's great. All right, we got one more.
This is it. This is the last one, man.
All right.
Make it good.
The status quo of rock and roll is quo. So we're going to play whatever you want, because this, for me, is just... I should have played it in the guitar section. I should have played it in the God section. It's just that guitar riff. They're UK boys, you know, they're British boys, and they're fucking... The first show outside of, like, you know, the US or Australia was with them.
Really?
Yep.
And they kind of invited you to come on the road with them?
In Sweden. It was in Sweden. We just did a support, and they were just like, we played with them. It was like, wow, you know? And they just, they started with Caroline. That was the opening track. And just they all walked forward and just kicked in that beat, you know? Like they're so good at what they do. And Whatever You Want is a world-class smash anthem. And when that guitar comes on, it just takes you to a place. Like, that riff just, like, it just takes you out there. And then when it kicks
in... And it has a whole line of people doing that, doesn't it?
Yeah. Everyone's got that shuffle, that beat, you know? And that's... To me, that's rock and roll.
Perfect. Thank you for your time once again, Joel. It's always good seeing you.
No worries.
Are we going to be doing any new tunes tonight? Are we going to be testing anything?
We've got 45.
You've got a few, haven't you?
Yeah, we've got a few, but we've got 45 minutes. So, mate, we got to jam it all in. And so we've sort of seen how we've gone every night, but we're just right on, and you know, you've got to be bang on.
Yeah.
You don't want to go over time.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's been really good so far, the tour with Maiden. It's been a lot of fun. You know, the crowd's been really liking it. And you know, the crew have been always...
What time have you been going on?
Oh, we go on about 7:30.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's on, smash it, and then are you sort of kicking it around and having a few beers after the show every night?
Mostly, yeah, because Maiden's playing, mate, so, you know, head to the bar straight away.
Well, listen, we'll be back there later, so we'll hopefully catch up and have a drink around there.
All right, cheers.
That'd be good. And again, next time, I was hoping to get you in the studio so we could do a proper takeover show style thing again, but next time you're back. Are there going to be any plans for, like, an Airbourne UK tour anytime soon?
Well, at the moment, we knock this one on the head. We do Maiden again tomorrow, and then we go over to Wacken and stuff in Germany with a few other festivals.
Have you played that festival before?
We have.
It's a great festival, I hear. I haven't been myself, but I hear it's...
They get something like 75,000 people there, but there's actually 90 because of the people that break in.
Yeah.
So everyone just goes and rips holes in
them. And there's just dumpsters full of empty beer cans, I hear.
Oh,
just
yeah.
Like
it's
dumpsters just and dumpsters.
Slaughterhouse of rock and roll. It's great. Well, the moment we go back to Australia, we're going to keep writing this album, and then basically we go from there.
Have we got any titles?
There is a few, but we don't know if they're going to be on the album.
Okay.
Yeah. So yeah, I'm I've got to keep it all under wraps.
Yeah.
Shh.
Is there any rough idea of when it might be sort of landing?
Oh, okay. So, well, roughly maybe mid next year or any earlier. That'd be probably the latest, I reckon.
Mid next year be the latest.
Yeah.
Wicked. Airbourne fans, keep your eyes out. Album number 3.
Yep.
It's on the way. Well, great to see you again, man.
Oh, cheers, mate. Great to see you again too. Always a pleasure.
Boom.
Have you seen this one?
No. How do you do that?
You just do that. Something like that.
Oh, nice.
And then you lock horns.
I'm sweating really bad, so I wasn't. That's why I did the.
It's all right. Then you lock your horns.
Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. And that's I've seen someone do that before.
Right there.
Yeah.
And then you're like, oh, that's disgusting. It's hot as hell on here, man. Is it this hot when you sleep?
The aircon broke. So.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Hence the just come out the shower look.
Well, yeah. Hence the hammer. To break the windows.
And you got your PlayStation 3 back there. Other than the push-up things as well, there you see.
Oh with, yeah, yeah.
They do like an MTV crib style thing.
Yeah, they're like Rhodesy's things. Yeah.
Are these them? To just to work on the guns?
Yeah, yeah.
So you put them down on the floor and...
Yeah, everyone has a go with them. They just sort of, there's like a Navy SEAL that brought them out. So everyone has a bit of a play with them.
Are all your crew Dutch?
No, just the driver, Tony, Super
yep.
T, and Geraldo's. He's the madman.
Is he?
Yeah, he's the one that gave you the beer.
Yeah, sure.
He drinks it just for the taste.
Cheers. Are you still doing the kegs on the tour bus?
Yep, downstairs.
Are they all dry? Are they still full?
A lot of them's dry. We've had to go back and get more. So
The old Sauv Blanc?
Yeah, there's always that kicking around. There's always a few bottles of red, a few bottles of white.
Have you been up to Scotland?
We did on this run. We played.
Oh, you went Glasgow and Aberdeen. And Aberdeen.
Yep.
Did you get any of the single malt up there?
The boys did, yep.
Yeah.
Got a bunch of that.
All gone?
Pretty much. There's a few things kicking around, but not much.
It's the end of the road. When's the last day? It's like two or three more shows you've got, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because Trivium do the Wembley show.
Yep.
Which is, it's like next Saturday, isn't it?
Yeah, I think it is, yeah.
And that's the last one.
Yeah. So then, we go over to Wacken and there's another big festival in Poland. It's like, they've got a lot of people at that one. It's a big festival. It's like 150,000, 200,000 people or something. It's mega. So we've got to play there. So it'll be a bit full on. It'll be good.
Well, listen, I'll let you get off. Thank you for your time. Joel from Airbourne, ladies and gentlemen. The hardest working man in rock and roll, just because he loves it so much.